Hi everyone, welcome to the LumaFusion video guide. I'm PhotoJoseph, and I'll be your host throughout this official training series. This series covers all aspects of using LumaFusion, from starting a project to layering video and effects to export. I want to give you a brief introduction to this course so you know how to get the most from it and how to find what you're looking for quickly. First and foremost, every video is titled with a number that coincides with the chapter in the LumaFusion PDF reference guide. For example, this is video 1-1, matching chapter 1 in the guide. This means you can watch the video, then jump to that chapter in the PDF for more information, or if you're reading the PDF and want to see something in action, you can quickly find the corresponding video in this series. You can find the written reference guide two ways. Within LumaFusion, tap the gear icon, then Help, then Reference Guide, and tap here to load the PDF. Or in any browser, go to the URL luma-touch.com/lfguide. I would also recommend saving a copy of the PDF on your iOS device so you can get to it even when you're offline. To do that, once the PDF has loaded in your browser, tap the Share button, then when you see this list of apps, swipe to the right, tap More, then scroll down and tap on Copy to Books. That will open the PDF guide in the Books app and sync it to your other devices. Once it's in Books, you can even add your own notes, highlights, and bookmarks to the PDF. Pretty handy. When you're watching these videos, because LumaFusion has a touch interface, there's no mouse to follow around the screen. What you're watching for instead are these blue touch indicators to show where I've touched the screen. If you ever feel like you missed a touch and want to see it again, just double tap on the left side of the screen to jump back 10 seconds. Finally, there's no right or wrong order to watch these videos. You can watch all of them from beginning to end, or jump around to learn about the features that you're most interested in. As you get towards the later, more advanced chapters, there will be some assumptions that you already know the basics. But if you ever have a question or are unsure of how something works, you can always go back to the earlier videos. Here again, the reference guide can come in quite handy. You could do a text search in the PDF for a term like markers, and see that in this case it's covered in Chapter 8. Then look for the videos starting with that number 8. We hope you find these videos useful and educational, and enjoy editing your video projects in LumaFusion.